Good morning, brothers.
Good morning.
Well, today we will see regarding marriage, sacrament of marriage in both Latin and Oriental codes. You know, Latin code is CIC 1983 and then CCO. Marriage is very, very important sacrament. Important sacrament for the or lay faithful. So there will be very many cases sometimes how we have to assist at marriage, who can assist at marriage, and what are this ones. Already we have seen the impediments regarding marriage. There are 13 impediments in CCO. In comparison to CIC, the CIC has 12 impediments, and then CCO has 13 impediments. What is that impediment that is added to those 12? Spiritual relationship, that's what godparent. So that becomes impediment in CCO. Now we will see first in this Latin canons without Oriental counterparts. Means Latin code has these canons, but Oriental code doesn't have these canons. So before this, I wish to say, what are considered as the main legal texts of the Catholic Church, which are those codes formed together as one legal text, which are the ones? Legal text, codes, how many are there? How many codes? One is Latin code, CIC, 1983, that's one. Other one? CCR. One more between these two, there is one more. See what happened when John Paul II promulgated CIC 1983. There are very few canons on Roman Curia. One or two are dedicated for Roman Curia. But it's a huge department, Roman Curia. Very, very important one, but only two canons. Then they asked, you have dedicated only two canons for Roman Curia, how come? Then he said, no worry, soon they are going to be for Roman Curia alone, there will be separate law, will be there, separate law. And that he promulgated in 1983, Latin code, 1990 CCO, but before CCO, he promulgated laws on Roman Curia regarding the functioning, all those things of Roman Curia. That is called, have you anybody heard? Good Shepherd, have you heard? Good Shepherd?
Yes,
in Latin, Good Shepherd, what is it called? Shepherd is?
Pastor.
Good means? Bonus. Pastor bonus, very important one. So these three together compile like one legal, one code, like CIC, pastor bonus, PB, and then CCR. These three together. So if somebody asks you, don't neglect pastor bonus. You say that in the Catholic Church, these three are there. Okay. CIC 1983, then pastor bonus, PB, in 1988, then CCO, 1990. One for Latins, other for Orientals, and this PB is for the Roman Curia. Okay. We'll take the first point, that is Canon 1061, paragraph 2 and paragraph 3. This canon speaks about ratified marriages, firstly. Then secondly, marriages ratified and consummated. Number three, putative marriages. These three things it speaks of. But this canon is not found in CCO. See there, when the marriage is ratified and non-consummated marriages, it's also there. Ratified and non-consummated marriages also will be there in this section, although it's not mentioned here. It's also there. So in such cases, who can dispense? Marriages which are ratified yet not consummated. Who can? Yesterday I said it. Who can? Who alone can do this? Roman Pontiff. Ratified and non-consummated. That means a valid marriage. Ratified marriage, let's say. Ratified marriage means according to the form it has taken place. That means there are two parties, an official witness is there, then two other witnesses are there, according to the formula, matter and form. Both are there. So it is ratified. But then it is not consummated. I have said also yesterday, what is meant by consummation? How it is considered as consummated? If those requirements are not fulfilled, it's not a consummated marriage. If it's not a consummated marriage, they cannot live together for long, very many times. So they want to partner. So what will happen? Then they have to file the application to the Roman Pontiff. Only he can dispense this. And then they can get married later on. But this, if this canon is not there in CCO, but the case can come also among the faithful of the Oriental churches, then what will they do? If there is no provision in the their court, Oriental court, they resort to, I have mentioned there, see that this canon is not found, but pastor bonus given on 28th June 1988 and became effective from March 1989, Article 67 empowers congregation for doctrine of worship and discipline of sacraments to examine all the acts concerning dispensation from ratified non-consummated marriages together with the votum. I said yesterday votum, no? Opinion or decision of the bishop and the remarks of the bond, and then submits a petition to the Supreme Pontiff requesting a dispensation. So they take this provision, pastor bonus, they will make use. Because before Oriental Code was promulgated, pastor bonus came in. So that doesn't require to be repeated in Oriental Court. That's why it's not there. It's already there in the universal law already, pastor bonus. Already this congregation is empowered to do these cases. So there isn't. But it is mentioned in the CIC because at that time pastor bonus was not promulgated still in 1983. That's why this canon was there in 1983. Do you follow? This is there in CIC and it's not there in CCO. This is the first canon which doesn't have counterpart in Oriental Court. Number two, I have already said in the past that canons regarding legitimate or illegitimate children and legitimated children, these canons found in CIC 1983, canons 11372-1140. But CCO removed the concept of illegitimate children, because it doesn't want to call children born out of this illegitimate union as illegitimate children. What the children has done to become illegitimate. So it has removed that concept. So that's why we don't find this concept of illegitimacy or legitimacy, legitimated children, all those things. Okay. Next, number three, marriages, canons on marriage contract through an interpreter, canon 1106 is not there in CCO. You have studied marriage, right? Sacraments, no? You have studied, I suppose. Then what does it mean? Contract through interpreter means? Through interpreter. Marriages contracted through an interpreter. What does it mean? What makes a marriage a marriage? First answer that.
Consent.
Very good. Consent. So consent has to be interpreted. Suppose You don't know how to speak. Proxy is different. Proxy means person is not there. So some other person is made as your proxy, means representing you. That's it. But here it is interpreter, means what the consent that is given to you, you can't follow. Suppose you don't know how to speak, dumb. Who knows whether that's the consent or not? So somebody has to interpret it, isn't it?
Yes.
Somebody should be given, he is saying like this. So he should interpret. That interpretation is not there in Sisya. So marriage can be contacted through interpreter in CCIC, that canon is there, but in CCO, it's not there. So that's the reason why sacred ministers, those who are assisting at marriage, are told carefully to examine the interpreter. First, the credibility or the, let's say, the truthfulness, trustworthiness of the interpreter is important. Only then you allow the person to interpret. Otherwise, what he says and what he interprets, if those two are different, means finished. That's why normal situations, sacred ministers are asked not to assist at these marriages unless they verify the credibility or the trustworthiness of the interpreter. Followed? Now you understand difference between proxy and interpreter. Okay, proxy means suppose you are somewhere else, so you have to get married, so he will substitute somebody else. Okay, proxy. Rare cases these are. Okay, not happening. Next one, number 4, delegation to a lay person to assist at marriage. CIC has two, who are those who can ordinarily assist at marriage, qualified as witnesses? Only clerics. That's a clerics, which means clerics include deacons, priests and bishops. One term, cleric, enough. Clerics. Only in extraordinary way only lay people can be delegated. Suppose a priest is not allowed to enter the territory, BJP or so many other things are there, or sometimes some militants may be there, so they threaten you, so you are not able to go to bless the wedding. Or sometimes wedding time was getting over, you are going on the way to wedding, but you met with an accident, so you are not able to go. And no other priest is available, but everything is prepared there. Omniprapta sunt means everything is ready, only you are not there because you met with an accident and you cannot be there. At that such kind of situations, he can delegate. I mean, that also, who is that? Diocesan bishop can grant that permission to delegate a lay person to assist at the marriage. But this is not there in CIC. Delegation of lay person to assist at marriage is not there in this one. And also, delegation to a deacon to assist at marriage is there in CIC, but it's not there for a CCO. What's the reason? Why deacons are not given that ordinary, this one, faculty to assist at the marriages? Why? CCO doesn't allow? What's there? The marriage? Why only priest? That means there's something only priest can do, only priest can give. What is that? Now, see, marriage in Oriental churches involves priestly blessing. Priestly blessing, very very important one for the comprehensive. Okay, very important. Why deacons are not allowed to assist at a Oriental marriage? Because it involves priestly blessing. So only priest can give that blessing. So deacon cannot give the blessing. Suppose, for the example, the same situation happened, accident, priest can't go, no others is available, In such cases, until then this cannot be taken place, marriage. Can't marriage take place until another priest is available? Until another priest is available, can't that marriage take, can't it be taken, taken place? At such situations, the lay people, lay person can be delegated. Okay? But then, soon after that, as early as possible, the wedded parties, the couple, have to go and get priestly blessing. Priestly blessing. At the earliest, they have to get. Okay? Just as we have this general confessions, no? During this corona, COVID time, no individual confessions possible. So, in some places, Vaishnava bishops allowed general confessions, general absolution, provided they approach at the earliest for the individual confession. Some question about it. Okay, then these are the canons, Latin canons, which are not there in a CCO. Now we see the other way about Eastern canons without the Latin counterparts. Eastern canons. Number one, a recognition of the marriage law proper to the baptized non-Catholics. Baptized non-Catholics means other Christians. CCO recognizes their marriage law, it respects, but this is not there in CIC. Number two, invalidating impediment of spiritual relationship. Already I have said, 13th impediment is there extra, which is not there in CIC. Number three, patriarch's faculty to bless Eastern marriages anywhere. He says the faculty to bless their own faithful anywhere, not only in his territory, in outside the territory also, anywhere he can bless these weddings. That is not there in CIC. Number four, blessing a marriage in a place exclusively of another church sui iris, unless local hierarch expressly refuses it. Another church sui iris. Normally, they are faithful in their church, marriages should be taken place. And in another church sui iris, within the same church sui iris, in different churches can be. Here, don't think of church sui iris means church building, no. We are saying that particular church, it can have many churches here and there. But outside their church also to take place, there is that provision is there, given is, that provision is given. For example, even Siro Malabars can get married in Latin church, can get married in Latin church, it gives. The church is same, other churches. Unless the local hierarch expressly refuses it. Unless he refuses in writing and so on. Expressly, that's what is called expressly refuses. Number five, Eastern marriage is to be celebrated before the pastor of the bridegroom, bridegroom's parish priest has to be taken. Whereas CIC doesn't say that. CIC doesn't say that, where it has to be taken and so on. We take it that, marriage should be there in Abai place law, they may say. But it's not there in law. Anywhere it can take place. Either in bridegroom's parish, or in the bride's parish, or even in the neutral parish. Neutral parish, a shrine, or another neighboring parish can take place anywhere. But whereas, normally, Eastern marriage has to be celebrated only in the before the pastor of the bridegroom. That pastor, parish priest, is important. That's the reason why you should know, you should be always in good contact with the parish priest. You can't ignore parish priest. Okay. Be good with parish priests. Okay. For sacraments. All the sacraments, very important. Because suppose some of us, some parish priests, really, it's true also. Even for ordination also. The candidate is seen only before ordination. Otherwise, whenever he came as a seminarian for holidays, he was never seen. Some parish priests really felt bad. That cannot take place. Whenever we go to parish, whenever we go for holidays, home parish, we have to meet the parish priest as early as possible. So after all, we don't need to go along with the suitcase to the parish presbytery and then show your face and then only go to the house. No, at least as early as possible, after reaching home, as early as possible, go yourself and present yourself before the parish priest and say that this is your plan. Holidays are from this day to this day, and during these days, suppose you are going out of the parish, inform the parish priest that I will not be available during these days, I will come back and like this. It's good always. Communion. You should have always this communion with the priest and so on. Okay? Then, 6. After the marriage, before the only witness, the spouses have to receive nuptial blessings from a priest as soon as possible. As I said, no? Before a lay witness, they have to receive priestly blessings. I already said it. Number 7. Faculty to bless marriage of the Christian faithful of an Eastern non-Catholic church. Eastern non-Catholic church. If those faithful cannot approach a priest of their own church without great difficulty, and if they voluntarily ask for the blessing, as long as nothing stands on the way of a valid and legal celebration. That means even non-Catholic faithful marriages also can be blessed here, provided everything is, all the impediments, everything is clear. Only then they cannot approach. Otherwise, normally we have sacramental sharing only. Which are the sacramental sharing? Which are the sacraments? Penance, Eucharist. This is only extraordinary. Okay? Not in regular way. Regularly you cannot do this. Yeah. Okay. These are some of the Oriental canons which do not have counterparts in Latin court. Now we see differences in parallel canons. Differences. Okay. Differences in parallel canons means both canons are there, but with slight difference. A slight difference. Very important one. Just check. First one, leaving the Catholic Church by a formal act. Formal act means kind of declaration. I'm leaving the church. Declaration. Okay. So a Latin Catholic who has left the church by a formal act is not bound by the impediment of disparity of cult. Disparity of cult. You know already. That means different religion. And his marriage with the non-baptized person is not presumed to be invalid. An Eastern Catholic is always subject. See that. Is always subject to this impediment, even if he declares. Through a formal act that he has left the Catholic Church, still he is bound by this impediment of a, which impediment? Disparity of cult. If I have not forgotten, I think Pope Benedict XVI modified this text in Omnium Mentum. Omnium in Mentum in 2009, he said, even if a person leaves the Catholic Church by a formal act, still he is bound by this disparity of cult. In similar terms as a Eastern Church, Eastern Court mentioned, you are leaving the Catholic Church by a formal act, but still when you get married, you are still baptized, no? Still baptized person. That's why you are bound by this impediment of disparity of cult. Okay. Number two, impediment of public propriety. What does it mean? Public propriety means concubinage, no? Concubine, without marriage, living together, living relationships, sometimes having children. Okay. Impediment. This CCO goes one step ahead, saying that even attempting to marry in front of the civil authority also comes under this public propriety impediment. It comes. Civil authority, registered marriages, no? Also form impediment. Number three, impediment of abduction. It's very very humorous, this is. Normally, who will kidnap? Man will kidnap woman, isn't it, to get married. CCO has gone ahead and thought for it and said, even woman also can kidnap, abduct a man, you know, to get married. Not just man alone, woman also is equal, almost equal share in abduction, you know, to get married. Okay, so that's what impediment. Yeah, CCO, not we, okay. CCO, yeah. When the law is practiced, very many things come out, then we rectify, okay. That's what is always updated, because times are not always same. The times change, so also the situations change, so also the modifications are to be made, to be done to the law. That's it. That's why now many are asking to revise CIC 1983, especially the book of sanctions. The book of sanctions asking to modify, because new cases are coming up, no? That's the reason. Anyway, we move on to the next one, that is impediment of affinity. CIC speaks of marriages in direct line as invalid. It says nothing about collateral line. Whereas CCO, it says of not only marriages in direct line, but also marriages in collateral line up to second degree as invalid. One doesn't speak of collateral line at all, Latin court. So it may be valid there. Whereas here, not only direct line, but also collateral line, even till up to second grade, it is invalid. Number five, marriages based on condition. Yeah, on condition. If you do this only, I'll get married. Okay. So CIC speaks of conditions for the future. Conditions for the future as invalidating a marriage. Whereas CCO, no past, no present, no future, no conditions are allowed. Any condition will invalidate a marriage. That means it should be conditionless. Unconditionally, you have to enter into the marriage. Very good aspect, isn't it? Unconditional love expressed, exchanged. Good thing. Number six, dispensation from canonical form. Dispensation from canonical form. Stopping. Okay. Dispensation from canonical form. CIC says local ordinary can give dispensation from the canonical form. Yeah. What does it mean by canonical form? Priest don't say, official, qualified witness, then two other witnesses. Yeah, this and the consent exchanged. This will form the form of a marriage, canonical form. So local ordinary can give dispensation, not the consent, but dispensation means so only one witness can be, as we said, no, one witness can be at times. Then CCO, dispensation is reserved to the round pontiff and to the patriarch. Here local ordinary means even a chancellor, suppose what's local ordinary, what does it mean by local ordinary? Bishops. Only bishops, Lock Lerner is the one who has executive power in the diocese. Executive power. Vicar General. Also is Lock Lerner. Yeah. Diocesan Bishop, Vicar General, Judicial Vicar sometimes, yeah. An Episcopal Vicar. All these have got executive power. Yeah. So they are called Lock Lerners. That's why I make difference between Diocesan Bishop and Lock Lerner. Diocesan Bishop is also Lock Lerner, but not every Lock Lerner is a Diocesan Bishop. Okay? Yeah, that's very clear. That's why sometimes now, bishops, Diocesan Bishop, that's why we never say Bishop. We always say Diocesan Bishop. Okay, Diocesan Bishop. Because there are other bishops also, no? Can be auxiliary bishop. You may add before bishop, auxiliary or coadjutor or titular, you may add. That's why, without giving you that chance, Diocesan Bishop. If you say that, nobody can add to that. Okay? So when you say the Diocesan Bishop, then he has that entire powers in the diocese. Okay. Whereas here, that's why Diocesan Bishop gives those powers, shares his powers with these Vicar General, Episcopal Vicar, and so on. He shares his powers, his executive powers, with them. But he doesn't share legislative power. Okay? Legislative power he cannot share. Judicial powers he can share. That is all we can say. Judicial Vicar is there in the diocese. And he can share executive powers. That's how we have VG, Episcopal Vicar, and so on. But not legislative power. Because making laws only he has to do. Making laws for his diocese. Okay? Followed. Okay. Here like this and leave like this. Okay? Oh. Okay. With this we have completed this topic. And we move on to the next topic, that is other sacraments. Here I imagine okay. Small text. Yes, brothers. Now, regarding other sacraments, only Oriental churches recognize this baptism, three types of baptism. Baptism by water, in desire, and by blood. So, baptism, confirmation, and holy orders. These cannot be repeated because they imprint on the faithful an indelible mark or the seal. Indelible means? Cannot be wiped out. The seal, once it is sealed, you cannot wipe it off. So that's called indelible mark. That's why once you are ordained, you are a priest for?
Ever.
What do you lose? If you suppose you apply for the dispensation, you lose clerical state you lose, that's all. Content will be there. So state you lose, that's all. Okay. Now we'll see in baptism, the sacrament of baptism, and then we compare and see. In baptism, first thing, ordinary minister. Who is considered as ordinary minister? Bishop, priest, and deacon. Clerics. Okay, these are the clerics. Whereas here, CCO, we have already said, deacon is not allowed, so he is not the ordinary minister of baptism. So bishop and priest only. Yeah. Please note, when ordinary minister is present, extraordinary issue will not come. Issue of extraordinary minister will not arise. Should not arise. In case of absence, physical absence or moral impediment, physical impediment and physically is impeded or morally impeded, only then extraordinary ministers coming. Okay? Suppose you are there already, you are available, there is no block for you to assist, minister the baptism, but still you delegate a layman in your presence to the Lord. Cannot be. Okay? Okay, we'll come to the next one. Then, godparents.
in same baptism, godparents. A Baptist member of non-Catholic ecclesial community. Non-Catholic means a Protestant, Lutheran, sometimes. Can be as witness together with Catholic godparent. Catholic godparent. Normally godparents are two. So one can be if needed. Okay, if needed only. If there are already two godparents, Catholic godparents, fine, no problem. Suppose some of the relations are can be. Okay. So baptism. So there can be witness only. Whereas here, CCO, for a just reason, a member of the Eastern non-Catholic Church. Eastern non-Catholic Church can be a sponsor or godparent together with they can be godparent. But here cannot be godparent, but only witness in CIC. Whereas CCO allows to be a godparent. This is about differences between CIC, CCO with regard to the baptism, ordinary minister and godparents. Next one, Eucharist. Eucharist. The matter, regarding matter. Eucharist is to be celebrated with bread and wine in which a little water is mixed, that you all know. Whereas here, there is no mention of mingling or adding of water to wine. Not mentioned. It's not mentioned. Why? Because they respect Armenian tradition, church, the tradition of that church. So there's no mingling there. That's why CCO, because CCO is a common law for all these 23 churches. So anything that is promulgated affects all the churches. So since they are the particular church, the tradition, there is no practice of mingling water in this one. So they did not make this rule. Did not keep it. Respect that. Okay. Next one. Concelebration. Nothing is mentioned here regarding our concelebration because all are Latins, isn't it? So no problem. Whereas here, see, different churches are there. 23 churches. So what about the concelebration? It permits concelebration between priests of different churches sui juris. It allows, provided under these conditions. Number one, permission of the eparchial bishop is there. Permission must be there. Number two, liturgical books are to be followed of that particular church, of that liturgy, of the principal celebrant. Number three, wearing the vestments of their own church sui juris. Their own vestments they have to wear. Just because celebrating with the other church, celebrant of the other church sui juris, I don't take that, but I wear my own. That's how I said, no? We come back to the first one. At the time of funeral of John Paul II, all these turbans, gowns, all those things are there. Because they are in their own vestments. They are in their own vestments. They were wearing their own vestments. And permission of the bishop was there. Then this one. Okay? So among those 23 churches, but also with the Latin church. They love this. Okay, Latin church. Concelebration with Latins also is the same, is applied. Okay, suppose we went in 2014, Kerala Society of India conferences, 5 days, took place in Palai Alphonsian Pastoral Institute. And from there, we went to Balanyanam. Was that one? Tomb. We had a mass at the tomb of Saint Alphonsa. And then principal celebrant was Sri Malabar, because it belongs to Sri Malabar. And we were in our stoles, our vestments. We were following the liturgical books, we are following. And the permission of the diocesan bishop was already given to us because he himself was the main celebrant. All these requirements are fulfilled. Concelebrant was allowed. Concelebration. You follow? Yeah. Just because it was that mass, we did not wear their vestments.
Okay. And we were not with Latin Eucharistic prayers and so on. No, those books are not there. There they have English translated books, so they get us. Next one, regarding penance. CIC, there are late sententiae excommunications, all mentioned in this. Late sententiae excommunications. You are already taught, no?
Yes,
sir. So, no need of going back. Okay. Then all these others incur late sententiae excommunications here. Late sententiae means ipso facto, the moment that you commit that sin, you are automatically dismissed. You are automatically excommunicated. Whereas here, there are no late sententiae excommunications. There is no late sententiae excommunication, very merciful. Yeah? So, reservation to the Holy See to absolve from two sins, and they are, number one, direct violation of the sacramental seal, and then absolution of an accomplice.
Okay.
Absolution of an accomplice in a sin against chastity. Reservation to the eparchial bishop is sin of procuring abortion. So, Holy See, Roman Pontiff, the reservation of the absolution is given, direct violation of the sacramental seal and sin against sixth commandment with the accomplice. Okay. That we have already said in the with regard to the late sententiae excommunications. I have said that there are two which are not reserved to the apostolic see. What are they? Here reserved to the apostolic see only sin of procuring abortion. Along with this, this is reserved to the eparchial bishop. Bishop can absolve this sin. Whereas Latin court, there are two sins which are not reserved to the apostolic see. Which are there? Along with this, diocesan bishop also can absolve from sin of abortion, procuring abortion. One more. Excommunication yet can be absolved. Which are those excommunications which are not reserved to the apostolic see? Two. One is already here. Okay. Another one. Apostasy, schism, heresy. My dear, pray that I don't come for your conference. Okay. These are the things to not reserved to the apostolic see. Okay. Next, anointing of the sick. The last topic, anointing of the sick. Oil is to be blessed by the bishop, as per CIC. And in case of necessity, any priest can bless the oil. In case of necessity, it is to be administered by the individual priest, single priest. It has to be administered in the sacrament. Yeah. Sick person implicitly requests for it. Implicitly requests. Why implicit? Why not? Why is it given also implicit? Explicitly, why didn't say? Why explicit permission? Explicit request from the part of the sick person. Why? Sometimes he may not be able to speak even. Do you like to receive? He may give a sign. Or he may also say. So explicit, not implicit. Or sometimes if you may be in coma, relations or somebody, they want, they ask for it. So you have to, this is called implicit request. Then what about Sisya? Oil is to be blessed by the very priest himself. Very priest, one who is administering the sacrament, blessed. Whereas there, bishop. When do they normally do that?
Chrism
Mass. All are seen like this. Then, it is to be administered by several priests as per the custom.
several trees, not just limited to one, can be many. A Catholic who is gravely ill, lacks consciousness or use of reason, is permitted at the request of the sacrament. Anybody, even if they don't, I said no, unconscious. So this is not mentioned here in CIC, but still it's implicit there. But whereas here, CCO gives elaborately, because what is lacking in a CIC, they try to make up, made up with that. Okay. So this is the end of our course on introduction to Oriental canon law. Thank you very much. God bless you in your exam.